Good evening, I'm Barkha Dutt. You're with The Mojo Story, our independent digital platform that brings you some of the most interesting voices from across the world. We're going to be speaking in a moment from now to India's greatest tennis legends. Let's bring up our special focus on this broadcast today. A new web series is about to hit a screen near you that's describing what it calls the bromance and then the breakpoint between Leander Paes and Mahesh Bhupathi. Now, this adaptation, as it were, of the real life drama of Leander and Mahesh's life is coming to you in this new series, which brings you a never before revealed truth and texture of these sportsmen's lives. Of course, their differences as well as their bonding played out in the full public gaze, but there's still some things that probably only both of them know and haven't shared thus far. Well, India's tennis greats, Leander and Mahesh, are going to be speaking to us in a short while from now on how and why they agreed to tell their story to the world in these web series. As we said, it's called A Breakpoint, and it looks at both the heartbreak and the hope that have defined the dramatic, highly successful lives of our two tennis stars. Let's bring them up on the screen now. It's a great pleasure to be joined by both Leander and Mahesh, who I think have been tennis legends for as long as I've been a journalist. So really, I think it brings home how long all three of us have been around. But literally, like, I remember starting my life in television and then kind of gawking at everything that was up with both of you. So great to be talking to you. Let me start by asking both of you, you know, I know that this new series by Ashwini Iyer and Nitesh Tiwari, you know, it's very exciting for the movie makers, but was it a difficult decision for both of you, given the fragility of your relationship, to agree to have your story told on screen? Leander, let me start by asking you that. How truthful is this series going to be? How much have you held back, if at all? And how difficult was the decision to say, okay, let's just tell our story now, even the untold bits?
Hi Barkha, it's an incredibly truthful story. And both Mahesh and I have been approached individually as well as a team to do this story over the last 20 years. But for me, what was really important was to have the right vehicle to tell the story. Mahesh and my career has spanned over 20 years, and hence to tell it in a 1.5 hour or a 2 hour feature film, I didn't feel that was the right way. So to have a docu-series told where each episode can deal with different nuances of what Mahesh thought at the time or what I thought at the time, or in this context, the way we've done it, is we've not used actors. We've actually done it ourselves. Our parents are in it. Our siblings are in it. Our coaches, trainers, friends are in it. So it's really raw. It's very real. My motive behind doing this, Barkha, was to inspire a whole generation through our story on how champions are built in India.
How difficult was it, Mahesh, the same question for you, for both of you to consent to this? Because did it first mean that you had to mend the broken bits between yourselves? Or in a way, did the broken bits remain as they were and get reflected in this 7-part series, Mahesh?
No, I think, see, we've been approached multiple times, both individually and collectively in the past. And I think it wasn't that the timing was never right. I think we were just not really interested in what people had to offer or the way they wanted to tell the story. And then, you know, one day, Vijay Subramaniam from Quan got us both on a phone call and said, listen, I know you've said no multiple times in the past, but you really need to get on a call with Nitesh and Ashwini, because you know, they've not only got the pedigree of, you know, being amazing filmmakers, but they have a very interesting take on how they want to tell the story, and they love tennis. So we got on that phone call, and I think very quickly it became apparent that we were very comfortable. Nitesh sir made it very clear that he was going to do all our bits individually. So there was no, you know, no holds barred, so that we could speak freely and not have not be uncomfortable that the other one was listening, and make sure he told the story independently, which I think was very important from both our perspectives as well, because, you know, over the years, when anyone speaks about Mahesh and Leander, the two perennial questions are why and what if. And, you know, we wanted to try and address that at the same time as bringing out our achievements, which I think he's done beautifully.
So that's very interesting that the bits with both of you were in a way filmed differently to allow for candor. But I guess, Leander, my question would be, did you guys, like, how would you describe, and I know this is an awkward question because here I'm not giving you the option to speak separately, but would you guys call each other friends, or is this like kind of like a post-divorce equilibrium? Leander, first to you.
You want to take that?
Yeah.
Well, basically, it's an amazing friendship that we have, and that has got all the mirch and masala in it. It's a brotherhood. It is a camaraderie. It is a championship-winning team. It's two young boys who had a dream at the age of 16 to win Wimbledon and be number one in the world. And then we persevered to do that. But then at the end of that, we've also dealt in this docuseries with our shortcomings. We've also dealt with the flaws that we have as individuals. And the hindsight, Barka, of this 20 years later is literally 2020, because in the journey of Breakpoint, when I looked at the archival footage of a certain look that Mahesh gave me after winning Wimbledon, where he's a reserved man, he doesn't really speak much. And the communication is sometimes a bit lacking. That when, if I had seen that look that he had given me, which I saw a couple months ago in the archival footage, maybe I could have realized what he really felt. Maybe if he saw me communicate with him a little more, maybe things could have been different. So hence, when we've delved into the realness of our triumphs and our tribulations at the same time, we've also been through a healing path through this Breakpoint journey, where we've realized things about each other that we did not address in the last 20 years. We spent so much time on Zoom calls, writing script, writing storylines that we've lived in real life. But we've also realized that, you know, we can laugh at ourselves now. We've got a bit more wisdom. We can look at ourselves and say, yaar, tune kya kiya tab, you know, or maine kya kiya tab. And that brotherhood is even stronger today. And that's the fun part for me.
Yeah. Would you use the word friends, Mahesh? I mean, Leander uses the word brotherhood, and it's very interesting. Like, I think people who are close and then a rupture takes place between them, it never takes away the familiarity, which is why they say the opposite of love is not hate, but indifference, right? It's when you actually stop quarreling with somebody that sense of intimacy goes. Mahesh, would you describe your emotion to Leander as indifferent, or has this process sort of helped get it to an old closeness, or do you think that can never come back?
It's clear that Leander and me share a bond that's very unique, right? I think a lot of people don't know that we meet a lot more often than people understand, because both our daughters, even though they're a few years apart, they go to the same school, they play tennis literally every day at the same club, so we run into each other very, very often. But, I mean, we share a bond, I think, like no other. You know, we started at ground zero. We conquered the world together. We went through a lot of highs and lows, tasted a lot of defeat, you know, climbed a lot of mountains. And, you know, I don't think we can kind of define that as friendship, right? Today, he needs anything. He knows he can call me. I need anything. I know I can call him. Because we will never kind of ignore each other, because, you know, we've been through that journey together, and nobody can understand it better than both of us. Nobody has lived it, honestly, in our country, so they will never understand it either. So when, you know, sometimes I tell my friends, hey, you know, our daughters were playing on parallel tennis courts a few days ago, they'll kind of say, oh, you know, they don't understand it, because it was an exciting moment for both the girls, right? Because they came. And, you know, my daughter interacted with Leander, you know, heard, I said a few things about her, Ayana's backhand to her when she was playing. But, you know, that kind of bond, I think, can never be replicated.
Yeah. So I'm almost hearing you guys say, and let me take that to Leander now, that this is a relationship perhaps for which there is no conventional name. But, you know, for anyone who's followed your lives, there's been, in a way, so much almost violent emotional rupture, right? Whether it's sort of Mahesh saying, hey, Leander decided not to play with me anymore, or Leander saying, Mahesh dropped me from the Davis Cup. I mean, just to pick up two big sort of big milestones of that disagreement that took place between both of you, by the way, in a very public domain. We've had leaked WhatsApp conversations, you know, we've had like full drama. Like, I think like nothing has actually been, you know, spared. And those are some of the headlines from that time. When you guys look back, is there anything you regret about how both of you behaved with each other? Leander, let me put that to you first.
Hey, this looks like season two, huh?
Yeah, I'm trying to ask questions in such a way that we don't give away what's coming in the series. But that's why I just, for myself, want to know, right? Like, do you look back and say, oh my God, you know, why did I lose my temper then? Or that thing that I did was a mistake, right? So without giving away the story, which I know you'd want people to see on the screen, Leander, is there something you look back and you regret?
I think the one thing that both of us would agree upon is that we were so young. And we were facing all the questions of aukat kya hai? Are you guys ever going to even play at Wimbledon, let alone win it? That then when we did win Wimbledon, when we did win the Grand Slams, when we did get to number one in the world, we didn't look beyond that. That we hadn't prepared ourselves for beyond that. So when the cracks emerged, I think we both would agree that if we had a senior voice or a wiser person there, a little older person that could actually guide us through that, that could actually take us through communicating better, leaving us in a room together where we could spend hours just telling each other what we also didn't like. Not just the fact of, hey, it was great to win Wimbledon, but what are your real feelings? Hey, it was great to go and get those 24 undefeated wins in the Davis Cup, which is a world record today, but let's go for ice cream together and just chat about what your emotions are behind that. Today, I think that we're both older, we're both wiser, and I'm really happy that we've gone through this journey of Breakpoint, because I know today that I could take Mahesh for an ice cream. I know if he does need something, I will always be there for him. Yeah. And I know the vice versa for him as well for me, because we've lived a whole life together. You know, there's a favorite, my favorite quote from a Rudyard Kipling poem, which sits at Wimbledon. It's a poem called If, yeah. And that quote says, if you can deal with triumph and defeat and still treat those two imposters just the same. Kind of sounds like our relationship a little bit. You know, we go through ups and downs, and we both got daughters that play tennis now. Maybe we have unspoken dreams that maybe they could create a partnership, or maybe they could win a Grand Slam together, or maybe they could, they're friends already when they go to the, you know, school together, or when they're on the tennis courts together, they basically tease us nonstop.
Do they know that their dads squabbled like children?
Not sure about that, but Hesh's daughter was really sweet. She actually, her first day at school, at Ambani School, she came up to Ayana, who's a couple years older than her, and she pulls on a uniform and says, you know, our daddies are friends. And Ayana said, yes, I do know. And if you need anything in school, I'm always here. So it was kind of really, it's really cool to see the next generation create their friendship as well. And maybe as they get a bit older, they'll get to see that, you know, their dads did it not too bad in achieving what we have achieved.
Yeah. You know, in every relationship, there is that inflection point, and two people don't always identify that tipping point as the same point. And I'm just wondering if both of you have the same inflection point as that break point, or is it different for both of you? So Mahesh, let me ask you that. You know, I remember reading that one stage where you come back from what you think is a sort of really successful win, and then you say to the media, you know, the decision to not play together anymore was Leander's, not mine. And I'll ask Leander the same question, but for you, was that the first break point? What was the break point? What would either of you identify as the break point, Mahesh?
I mean, I don't know how to answer that. We had multiple breakpoints in our career, right? So Are we referring to the between
each other? When does your relationship change? What is that point that you, because you do come back from that break point, right? You guys stop playing together and then you reunite a couple of years later again, and you go and play at the Olympics. Now, my question is, sometimes they say when the relationship breaks, it never really recovers. And I'm just wondering what both of you identify as that first break point from after which the relationship was never the same again.
Yeah, I think, firstly, I think a lot of people have to watch the show to get that. Secondly, you know, I think our relationship was so personal and emotional, right? I mean, Leander and me, when we started off, I mean, we literally spent the whole day together, right? So we kind of understood each other really well on and off the court. And I don't think there was a specific point specifically for me or him, or, you know, jointly. I think it just came to that comfort level at some point. It could have been on the court or it could have been off the court, that, you know, we felt like either we needed a break or we were forced to take a break. I mean, in the first one was, I think, driven by my surgery. It wasn't something that was planned, and that kind of snowballed into our first break. The second one was just result oriented, and the third one, again, you know, was result oriented, I think, but, you know, maybe Olympic oriented. So it wasn't specific, and I think it's totally different for both of us.
And let me ask you the same question, Mahesh. Is there a period that you look back at and say, hey, I wish I hadn't done that? Like, I wish I hadn't shown our WhatsApp exchange on television. I wish I'd just communicated more. I'm too reserved. It could be anything. And I'm asking both of you. Like, you know, we all look back and I personally, for example, often look back at my own life and say, oh God, I wish I hadn't cried then, or I wish I hadn't lost my blown a fuse then. So I'm just wondering whether you guys have specific regrets. So to you, Mahesh, first.
I mean, you know, maybe 10 years ago, for sure, I did not know the concept of sleeping over it. You know, I reacted a lot of times emotionally without, you know, thinking through the repercussions. And today, you know, 10 years later and a lot older and wiser, I would probably say that, you know, I should have thought it through, or maybe even discussed it with others, if not even with Leander, before, you know, just picking up the phone and calling him and asking him why he said that, or did he actually say that before reacting. But honestly, and I'm saying this for both of us, right? Because, you know, we've been through this journey for the last 18 months. I think a lot of it was fueled by, you know, unwanted elements. You know, when I was in New York, healing from shoulder surgery, and there were comments coming about Leander not wanting to play with me because he had no idea how my shoulder would be. I think the right thing for me to do at that time was to probably pick up the phone and call Leander and say, dude, you know, what's going on, you know, and sort it out then and there. Instead, you know, the media was prodding me, and I reacted. So, Yeah, I mean, obviously, yeah, sleeping over it would have been a good first move from my part.
Yeah, that's pretty candid. Leander, would you say that you made the same mistake, that basically you were like tempestuous boys who went from, what did you guys do on court, that chest bump? This is a chest bump romance to like just, yeah, there it is. To like just, you know, going off the deep end whenever you felt. Like, were you too emotional? Were too tempestuous, too volatile, Leander?
I think we were so engrossed, Bharka, in achieving success that we forgot to actually step back and really keep rekindling that passion that got us that success. So as 16-year-olds, 18-year-olds, 20-year-olds, 25-year-olds, we had that passion of watching maybe Sholay 105 times, listening to Kishore Kumar, going off and getting a Karnataka Bhavan South Indian meal together. Or when we were traveling internationally, we would have that Indian desi flavor with us all the time. Yeah. But then, like anything that achieves success, there are a lot of hanger-ons that come. There are a lot of unwanted people and things that actually come on that kind of have their own reasons to be there. But what we forgot to do was to keep that individual celebration of two young Indian boys going. We wouldn't have meals together alone. We wouldn't go to movies together alone. We would not communicate as well as we would. We would use our coaches to communicate, or we'd use the other people in our lives to communicate. And I think that's a responsibility that we both take. And that's a realization that we both have now, that as much as we are such different individuals, our characters are different, our personalities are different, the way we communicate is different. But that's also probably what makes it yin and yang. That's also probably what makes Mahesh's strengths my weaknesses, my strengths his weaknesses. And that's what made us world champions. But as much as hindsight is 20/20, I definitely feel the one thing, Barka, that would have made a difference was if we could actually look beyond winning the Grand Slams. If we could look beyond being number one in the world, what was the next goal? What was the next achievement? And how were we going to achieve that? Would have probably kept us together for another 4 or 5 years.
So why didn't that happen? Do you blame the management of how tennis is managed in this country? Do you blame other people? Do you feel other people made mischief with a growing rift? Why didn't this happen? Why couldn't you look beyond and say, okay, what's next for us? Why do you think, Leander?
You know, as much as we could pinpoint one story and say this person played mischief there, or pinpoint another story and say that person played mischief there, or at the end of the day, it's our responsibility. At the end of the day, we are the ones who came together at 16 and had a dream. We are the ones who put in the hard yards. And that's what I respect about what both Mahesh and myself have done, is that we put in the hard yards to be Wimbledon champions. But I think we got so engrossed in just achieving that, that maybe we needed an elder statesman who was a little wiser than us, a little more forthright than us, a little better traveled and someone who had been through toughness in life, who actually knew how to either sleep over it at night or knew how to communicate a little better or knew how to put an arm around the other person's shoulder and saying, you know, I don't understand you, but that's perfectly fine. I still got you. You know, and that's the friendship and the brotherhood that we have today, is that I may not understand everything Mahesh does, but I still put my arm around him and say, I'm right here for you.
And I want to know how that actually happened. How did that healing happen? But first, to both of you and Mahesh, a whole bunch of other players got caught up in what was then described as almost like a camp war in the world of tennis. You had, you know, Sania Mirza and Rohan Bopanna also sort of going, literally going to battle with Leander. There was this sense that you had to take sides. In the process of you guys making up, have all of those relationships patched up as well? Or do you feel that those damages are kind of permanent? Mahesh, to you first.
No, I don't think any damage in terms of relationships were done. I mean, Rohan and Leander played last few years together in Davis Cup. Sania and Leander played at the Olympics last year. I mean, I think friendships off the court and on the court are very different, especially when you're playing for your country, right? Everyone, I mean, dream is to play for your country, dream is to win for your country. And that's the standard and that's the constant with the professional athletes. So, yeah, I think, I mean, I don't know. I think, Leander, I think your relationships with them are intact, if I'm not mistaken.
You know, but I remember interviewing Sania just coincidentally at a time when I think she'd had this big bust up with Leander. And more than Leander, it was with, you know, decisions being taken for her on who she should play with. I think it was more that than a personal fallout with Leander. So, Leander, how is that equation with Sania Mirza today? You're on mute.
We played at the Olympics together as well. And there's tremendous respect back and forth. Also, Sania and myself are quite similar in terms of feeling magic and executing magic on a tennis court. So in that, whenever we see each other, we talk about, you know, the fun times that we've had or things that we've done and achieved together. From my perspective, I have tremendous respect for her because of the fact that she's India's first female Grand Slam champion. I mean, phenomenal effort. And as much as at different times of our careers, there have been people who have been involved in the Leander Mahesh story, whether it was Rohan or whether it was Sania, and they might have felt they got a raw deal because of what Leander and Mahesh were going through. My God, Sania and me came really close to winning an Olympic medal in London. And we were literally one shot away from being in a position to covet that medal. And eventual team that we lost to went and got medals and got onto the podium. So that being said, I think that all four of us are Grand Slam champions. Rohan's won one Grand Slam, Sania's won a few. And between Mahesh and myself and both of them, India's won about 30 to 35 Grand Slams. So the question is now to nurture the next generation. And I'm hoping that this docu-series inspires the next generation that it doesn't matter who's right or wrong. It doesn't matter if Mahesh is right or wrong or Leander's right or wrong. Or what matters is how do you achieve success? And what is that like?
And absolutely. And I think the way to also understand in some ways why people fall out, why relationships get damaged is that word called passion. You know, and today, Leander, you can sit and say, hey, we wished we'd look beyond the Grand Slam. But when you're young sports people, who looks beyond the next big title? Like, it's easier said than done. What I want to understand, and I know you can't give away the whole story, but a little bit of it is, how did you guys make up? Like, how did it come to some sort of healing from that break point? Who picked up the phone first? Did that wise person that you missed in your younger years finally surface? Mahesh, how did it happen? How did you guys start talking again?
No, we haven't really made up yet, Varka. We're sitting in two different houses on Zoom talking to you, right? So,
when was the last time you met?
Well, like I said, we keep running into each other at the club literally every other day because of our daughters. But when was the last time we met? We did the final shot of the show together in Bangalore maybe 3 weeks ago.
And how was that?
It was actually fun. I think, like I said, the bond that we've created, you know, over the last 20 years is pretty tight. So even though, you know, like Leander has articulated in the show that, you know, we live literally 15 seconds away from each other, but I've never been to each other's house. But every time we do meet or are left alone in any kind of environment, you know, there's so many stories and so many memories that we get along great.
Yeah, so I want to understand this equation. We haven't really made up. Sounds to me like dysfunctional love. Is that the phrase that you would use? No, wait. I'm not done asking you yet. Hang on, because you're the one who self-professedly is less communicative. So you need a little more prodding. So here's the question for you. You haven't really made up. You've never been to each other's homes, but this series has happened on your entire relationship. There's a great deal of knowledge about the other person. You probably know each other better than anyone knows both of you. What's the phrase that you'd use if you haven't made up? You're not exactly friends. You're no longer partners. What's the word you'd use to describe your feelings for Leander Mahesh?
So, with me, it's very different, right? I mean, Leander was, you know, when I was a junior, Leander won Junior Wimbledon. When I was in college, Leander was, you know, beating France in Fréjus in Davis Cup, literally single-handed. So when I came up, I was kind of a fan of Leander Paes, right? And then fan transcended into friend, transcended into partner, transcended into, you know, winning Grand Slam. So, you know, I have this emotional connect with Leander that, you know, most of the decisions I've made through all the breaks that we've had have been emotional, maybe not all the right ones, which I've also kind of articulated in the series, but it was always emotional. But again, you know, the fact that we won as much as we won and we have all those records sitting besides our name still makes me extremely proud of all the decisions I made.
Yeah. So Leander, because Mahesh won't answer it, let me try the same question with you. What is this equation? You live 15 seconds away from each other. You don't go to each other's homes, but you feel intimately connected, but you haven't really made up. It seems to me like it's like people we've known all our lives, but we know if we come too close, we'll fight. So we know each other, we care for each other, but we're like, hey, let's just keep a distance. Is it kind of like that? Like, help me here.
I'll give you one word to describe it. Brotherhood.
So it's like siblings fight, but they love each other. Is it like that?
Exactly right. We're only about a year apart. His birthday is on the 7th of June. Mine's on the 17th of June. And it's literally like big brother, young brother. It's the best way I could describe it.
But siblings do meet. So when you guys bump into each other, do you talk for long? Do you just say, hey, dude, what's up? Like, what, do you have a conversation when you guys meet? Or is this like the first time you've been put together in a conversation together for so long? Leander?
You see how awkward he's sitting there? He's got his hand on his chin. And he has no clue what to say. So I'm always the one in thrust in front to actually defend us or talk about us or take the mic and speak.
Yeah, but and then, every relationship has one such person. I'll tell you that.
You know, but it's just a brotherhood. I mean, we a big brother, young brother. Sometimes we have differences and we fight like cats and dogs. And sometimes we can sit and look at our daughters play and go, oh my God, can you imagine both of them playing on the same court? Or sometimes, you know, when I'm going through a little bit of trouble, he'll be there for me. Or when he's going through a bit of trouble, I'll be there for him. And I think going through this whole docuseries, it's been really cool to actually spend time together. You know, yeah. For me, it's been very unique to see the perspectives of our families and our parents and our siblings and our coaches and friends around who are going through that with us. But specifically for Mahesh, it's a brotherhood. We have a very unique relationship. It's quirky, it's unique, it's simple at the most heightened of times. When we either of us or when both of us are under extreme pressure, there's just such a simplicity to our friendship. We're just there for each other. Mm-hmm. And yet when everything's going really well, we're both a little awkward. We're like, are you leading? Am I leading? What? You know, so in that, I just think it's a wonderful brotherhood. And if I could speak to that 16-year-old again who had that dream the first time I saw Mahesh, on feeling that I could win Wimbledon with him or I could be number one in the world with him and build an incredible Indian journey with him, I'll tap him on the back and I'll tap young Mahesh on the back. He was 15 at the time, right, Hesh? And basically say, well done, you know, through all the ups and downs, we got each other's back and we achieved what we said we would. So well done.
Yeah, I have to close, but I have to ask both of you this question. What is it that you hope, you know, you have hopes for tennis, obviously, nurturing young talent to inspire young people when they see this series. But what is it that you hope for yourselves and your relationship now? What was the toughest part of doing this series and something that you now feel, okay, we got past that. Now maybe we're ready for the next step. Mahesh, to you first.
So I think throughout our careers, when Leander and me were together, you know, there was a different dynamic in general. I mean, it was like almost 1 and 1 was 11, right? I mean, that was on the tennis court, off the tennis court. I mean, when we walked into a room, it was different when I was alone or we were together. So I think, you know, maybe this is our first step into, you know, doing different things. I think one thing we both would be passionate about doing is helping sport and in specifically even tennis in our country, because no one knows how it's done like us. And that's a fact, no matter who debates that with us. And, you know, we've always been open and vocal that, you know, we should be supporting in some form or the other, the next generation, future generations. So, yeah, I mean, there's a lot we can do together. And I think this is the first step in that.
Well, I think in some ways, Leander, the first step might be for you guys to actually meet and spend some time like together at length. Do you feel you're ready for that? Or do you feel like, Mahesh, that you haven't really made up despite the brotherhood? You're on mute, Leander. Hang on.
Well, I feel we've always been ready to accept an invitation. If Mahesh asks me to do something, I'll do it with him. If I ask him to do something, he'll do it with me. But the awkwardness comes in the taking the initiative. So I'll do that right now. Next time you're in town, you're invited home for some good fish curry, man. Come on
yeah,
over.
Yeah, see, it wasn't that difficult. Mahesh, you just have to say yes, right? I mean, the point is...
He knows I don't eat seafood, by the way.
Oh,
my bad. Then you get a nice butter chicken, dude. There you go. How's that? That used to be your favorite.
Say yes now, Mahesh. Say yes. I feel like I have to be the mediator. I'm going to follow this up and find out if this actually happened. I have both of your numbers. I'm going to follow this through. After the series is out, you guys have to do this dinner. But in the meantime, fascinating 7-part series, Breakpoint, on the astonishing, dramatic, high-achieving journey of legends is on your screen very soon. Do look out for it. Both men you just heard promised that it's extremely honest. They weren't put in the same room together, so they were able to talk less polite than they've been now. But politeness is not a bad thing. And as both of them said, the word they use, even with all the dysfunctionality, all its flaws, all its problems, is brotherhood. Keep shining, Leander and Mahesh. Thanks for talking to us. And we're looking forward to the series. Thanks for talking to us. Bye. Take care.
Thanks, Varka.
It's great to see you here. Thank you for watching our work.
If you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to click the bell icon and subscribe to Mojo Story and support independent, robust journalists.